Hello, everyone, and welcome back to another episode of Investing for the Common Man, where my mission is to not only help you save money, but more importantly, your valuable time with short, concise, instructional videos. Have you ever set aside money to invest only to realize that you have no idea what you should buy? Maybe you were tempted to just dump it into some random index funds and call it a day. Well, in this video, we will learn how to identify companies that have the potential to substantially outperform general index funds. We will build on a few concepts that I introduced last week in my video on factors that affect the price of a stock. I'll leave a link to that video in the description below in case you missed it. While you're at it, why not go ahead and subscribe and hit that like button. To make money on a stock, you need to buy low and sell high. Dividends can also help increase your returns over time, but the main driver of profit is often increases in valuation. But when you are shopping for stocks, how do you know which companies are likely to be profitable and whether you are buying at a good price or a bad price? To be a wise investor, you need to develop at least a rudimentary understanding of how a company operates. Not just what their product is, but how they monetize that product and what sorts of changes in the economic environment might affect their revenue or expenses. If you are relatively new to investing, I would start off by focusing on companies that you know about and understand. You may not already know everything about how a company with a household name like Google operates, but that's where you can use research to fill in those gaps. Let's consider Google for a second. Google is a massive company. Everyone has heard of Google. They run the world's most popular search engine and offer a multitude of different software and services. But the question is, how does Google generate revenue with those services, most of which are free? The simple answer is advertising, but there's far more to it than that. You should spend at least a few minutes researching how a business model works before you decide to invest. If you come across a company with an exciting looking stock chart, but the business model is so convoluted that you can't wrap your head around it, you might be better off if you pass on that one and look for another opportunity. Once you have a basic understanding of how a company operates, you need to consider competition. Competition is the heart and soul of our free market economy. If you want to invest in a company, you should look for their competitive advantages and economic moats. A competitive advantage helps a company become more profitable than its rivals. Examples of competitive advantages are cost structure, branding, product quality, distribution network, intellectual property, and customer service. Competitive advantages, though, may come and go over time, so it's also important to look for economic moats that protect a company's competitive advantages. The term economic moat was coined by the infamous Warren Buffett and refers to a company's ability to maintain its advantages over its competitors and protect its long-term profits and market share from competing firms. There are five basic types of economic moats: low cost production, high switching costs, network effects, intangible assets, and efficient scale. I want to keep this video short and sweet, so instead of trying to break down each one of these individually, I'll leave a link in the description below where you can learn more about economic moats and how they work. All of the ways that we've looked at so far to evaluate a stock have been conceptual and can be disputed or interpreted subjectively by different investors. But numbers don't lie, so we should also look at some cold, hard data to inform our investment decisions. Companies publicly release performance data and balance sheets every quarter, so you should be able to easily find this data either directly on your trading software or from a free online source like Yahoo Finance. If you use TD Ameritrade's Thinkorswim platform, you'll find this data in the Fundamentals tab. And if you use Webull, it'll be in the Financials section. Now, the sheer amount of data here can be overwhelming, so today we are just going to look at three things. One of the biggest drivers of stock appreciation is company growth, so the first numbers that I like to look at are earnings per share and free cash flow per share. If these numbers are generally increasing over the past 5 to 10 years, then the company is experiencing growth. If earnings per share is all over the map, not trending upwards or downwards, it can suggest that the company's profits are unreliable. Negative earnings per share can also be a big red flag because it means the company is losing money. Sometimes you will see young companies, especially tech companies, with negative earnings because research and development and building up the infrastructure for an efficient and profitable business is expensive and takes time. You might consider investing in a company with negative earnings if it looks like the company is trending towards profitability. A good example for this are the fundamentals here on Square, ticker symbol SQ. You can also look at growth rates that have already been calculated to get an idea of growth potential. The next thing you need to look at before you invest is the amount of debt that a company has. Most companies have some long-term debt, and that's fine as long as they can continue to pay the interest on that debt. But when crisis hits, large amounts of debt are the biggest threat to sending a company tumbling into bankruptcy rather than weathering the storm and recovering. Right now, we are indeed living in one of those periods of crisis. With the global pandemic raging and many companies suffering with decreased or even non-existent revenues, the companies with high levels of debt are at incredible risk of not making it through this. You can evaluate a company's debt by either looking it up on their balance sheet or looking at the long-term debt-to-equity ratio. You can compare this debt ratio to that of a company's competitors to decide if a company is over-leveraged and has taken on too much risk to be a wise investment. Okay, so now you've done your research and found a stock that you really like. Stocks are constantly fluctuating, so how do you know if the current share price is a good value or not? You may have done great analysis, but if you buy into a stock when it is overvalued, you will likely lose money in the short term, and it could be months or even years before you recoup those losses and start to make money on the investment again. So rather than lunging headlong into a stock, it is often better to put it on a watch list and wait for a bargain. When you are looking for bargains, it is important to check the price-to-earnings ratio, also known as the PE ratio. This metric compares the current price of a stock to a company's recent earnings. It depends on the industry, but a good PE ratio can be generally somewhere between 10 and 25. But some tech stocks can even get up to a ratio of 100 or more, which can be a big red flag. One method is to compare the current PE ratio to the average PE ratio over the last 5 years. If the current ratio is significantly higher, then the company might be overvalued. If it is significantly lower, you might be looking at a bargain. You can also use a relative strength index tool on your trading platform to watch for overbought and oversold conditions on the one-year chart. All right, let's do a quick recap. To pick stocks successfully, you need to understand the company's business model, identify competitive advantages and moats, look at historical growth trends, evaluate a company's debt load, and hunt for bargains. Any one of these data points is not enough on its own to make wise trading decisions, and sometimes you might even find conditions that are favorable enough to make up for a bad data point or two. If you haven't caught on yet, the key to picking stocks successfully is careful research and patience. When you find a company you like, put it on a watch list and wait for the right opportunity. You might only make one or two trades a month, and that is okay. No one will ever be able to accurately pick the bottom, so you can scale into a position slowly as you wait for better and better deals to lower your cost basis without missing out on upside exposure. I want to end this video with a few wise words from Warren Buffett. Never invest in a business you don't understand, and risk comes from not knowing what you are doing. If you like this sort of content, please take a moment to like and subscribe. I'm always happy to answer any questions you might have in the comments below. Until next time, keep calm, stay healthy, and happy trading.